show so far, starting early this morning. Well, Lee Zeldin was great. Bill O'Reilly was, he's the best ever. And then we had somebody else on at 7:05. It was like really good.
Oh, yeah.
Curtis.
Yeah, very good.
Well, Curtis does a show with Anthony Weiner, you know, on the weekends. They do this Left vs. Right, which I believe is 3 to 4 every Saturday. And before that, Anthony does his own show from 2 to 3. It's called The Middle, where Weiner, who is a, a liberal with a capital L, fakes it and tries to get somewhere near the middle, but it's really disingenuous. But as I say that, he's sitting right in front of me. And here's our friend, 2 to 4 Saturdays, Anthony Weiner. Good morning, Anthony. How are you?
Good morning. You got a little taste of Curtis as when the dial switched to 10 this morning. He was now you know what I have to do with
it. Yeah, it's not easy.
It's like kind of squeeze a word, but he is amazing. How are you?
He was funny today. He was. I'm good, thank you. You too. He was funny talking about the whole Mayor Eric Adams thing. I do want to get to this story out of UK though. It's a big story. If you don't know, folks, after just 44 days, Liz Truss has quit as the prime minister after she replaced Boris Johnson this morning. She was went through a lot there in 44 days. The Queen died when after she took over. Obviously, the economy is a mess. The energy issue is huge. And the party there, the Conservative Party, has been taking a beating. So once again, after 44 days, Liz Truss said, like Roberto Duran, no mas. What do you know about that?
Well, this is their third prime minister in a year. Remember, Theresa May came in after Brexit. They tossed her to the wolves. Look, I did a whole episode about this on The Middle. There's a lot of things about the British system you like. You know, we Democrats, if we had the ability to throw out our leader in the middle of a term, we would probably have done that with Biden.
You tried 100 times. Oh, with Biden. You see what you did? You were in the middle. Because you tried with Trump about 100 times.
Well, but the thing that's going on there, the problem with the parliamentary system is, you know, you vote for the party and then the party leaders get together and choose their leader. And it doesn't necessarily mean they get someone with good political skills. But in this case, she did exactly what the Conservatives wanted to do. She proposed this giant tax cut that was unpaid for, and basically there was a rebellion among the people, and then all of her colleagues ran away from her. But it is a mess there. But interestingly, there, right now, the Conservatives, they're the fourth most popular party. They're going to get swamped. And some people think that what might happen next is they may call an election or something, but it's a mess there. Some of the countries of Europe are moving to the right. Some are moving to the left. The common theme, and it's true here too, you don't want to be an incumbent right now. No one wants to be in office right now because people are pissed.
Yeah, somebody said that to us yesterday too, that the incumbents are in big trouble here in the United States. Well, let's get to it then. They were 18 days away from the midterms. And there seems to be, again, this thought, and everybody's there now, everybody, that there's going to be a huge red wave. The House easy, the Senate maybe getting easier, leading up to the big election in 2024. Zeldin, he's going to beat Hochul, and Walker's going to win in Georgia, and Oz is going to beat Fetterman. These are some predictions from very smart people who just weeks ago said that wasn't going to be the case. What do you think?
Yeah, I mean, this is a case the Democrats might have peaked too soon. Right after the combination of the decision on Dobbs and the fact that Biden finally was able to get some bills passed, Democrats had a little bump, but now it's starting to recede a little bit. But the way to look at this stuff is not any one poll. You look at the average of the polls. These things are very the fundamentals, as they say, are great for Republicans. Inflation is high. Unemployment, you know, the economy is a mess. The in party is unpopular. This is a good time to be a Republican. I'd rather be a Republican than Democrat right now. I still think that the Democrats are going to hold on to the Senate, but it's going to be very close.
Oh, you do?
I do. I mean,
what race do you like? You think Fetterman? Do you think Warnock?
Well, these are you've been talking about the big races. Fetterman is still up by a couple of points on Oz.
I don't know how, but
you've
he is.
Got, you know, Arizona. Kelly is still leading Masters
he's
in Arizona.
He's got a nice lead. Yeah.
Wisconsin. Johnson seems holding on. That guy is one fry short of a happy meal. But he's holding on because what they did is they plastered this guy Mandela Barnes on crime, just like what's going on here.
He got
killed on it.
Right.
And Ohio's the wild card. Although the Democrats seem to be holding on, Ohio's red at this point. So
J.D. Vance kicked the living daylights out of Tim Ryan a couple nights ago.
Oh, I got to tell you something. You got to look at that tape of Ryan calling Vance a basically calling him a wuss.
He did say that.
And
yeah.
that was...
Yeah. That was good. He had one moment.
He had one punch.
We'll he landed one punch.
And
otherwise,
Vince,
he got his ass kicked.
I gotta tell you, the problem with Vince, he's such a phony. You go and read his book, well, Hillbilly Elegy.
He's my friend. He's not a
All right,
take
fair
that
enough.
Back.
Fair enough.
No, I don't
take
even know
back.
That. I have no idea who he is. I don't care. I just wanted to win because I want Republicans to win. I'm interested, if you were still running for office, the mandate, it seems like, maybe mandate's the wrong word, you can correct me, but it seems like the mandate is abortion. You got to talk about abortion or maybe gun laws because you can't win on anything else. If you're running for office right now, you're going to waste my time in a state where it's legal with abortion? Really?
Well, first of all, you know, you made fun of it before, but like I could not get elected in my district today because as a guy who is kind of fairly pro-cop, I sponsored the cops program. I was hawkish
on
Israel.
Fairly pro-cop? How about I smack you right now? What do you mean fairly pro-cop?
Well, I know that no job is 100% anything.
Oh, get out of here.
So
stop it.
Why is it I start to say something that shows that I'm more moderate, you stop me on the one
because
liberal
thing. Because I don't want to hear fairly pro-cop to
see,
say
this
I'm pro-cop.
Well, this is why I have a show called The Middle and you have a show called Wackadoo Right. That's why we have different shows.
Wait a second. I'm pro-choice.
That's the point.
I'm for gay marriage.
And you believe the election was on the level.
I don't believe that the election was on a level.
Okay, well.
But when I tell you that, hold on. I'm not talking about them finding touchdowns at 4 o'clock in the morning so the Chiefs really beat Brady and the Buccaneers. Forget about that.
Right.
What I'm talking about is...
Which is what Trump believes.
Right, that's fine.
And which is what Zeldin came out in favor of.
Not in favor
that's
of.
That's Zeldin voted to throw out our votes. Our votes as New Yorkers. Okay. He voted to throw them out. Why can I trust that guy?
My issue is, oh, really?
Yeah.
You could trust Hochul, that evil biatch?
Hey,
really?
You can trust her? Yeah, well, listen, I know she's on the big constitutional issue of the day, choice. She's on the right side.
Who cares?
And anyone who believes in throwing out election results, my election results, I don't want him anywhere near power.
Okay, he didn't believe that. That's first of all.
That's right, because he was posturing for Trump. I don't like that either.
Well, it's fine, but let's get back to where the election was rigged. When you've got a story about the president's son, which is all true, every bit of it, money taken from every country around the world.
In every newspaper. It was in every newspaper. Don't tell me about cover-up. It was in every newspaper.
Oh, really?
The New York Times had it.
What about Google? No, they did not have it. The New York Times and the Washington Post carried it later and admitted
who had the laptop.
That the Post was
who had the laptop and wouldn't share it with anyone else?
The FBI.
No.
Yes.
No, the New York Post.
Yeah, and New York
and they
Post
wouldn't share with any other publication.
Miranda Devine wrote the story. You had Tony Bobulinski, Anthony, on with Tucker Carlson before the election, but Google wouldn't allow it. Facebook wouldn't allow it.
That's not true. It's not true.
It's 100%
true. It's not true about Google.
It is true.
Facebook and Twitter both made a mistake on that, but don't say it wasn't covered. It was in every freaking newspaper.
Did you just say made a mistake?
Yeah, they got that wrong.
Oh, they got it wrong. Yeah. Isn't that a nice way of saying the corrupt bastards found a way to rig the election?
October, he didn't mean to kill her.
He stabbed her 18
times. Let me ask you. If you went to the New York Times and you said, hey, cover this story, but we're not going to let you see the laptop. All you can do is read about it in the New York Post. You know who made that decision?
No, I don't. Who?
We don't know who made that. Basically, Rudy Giuliani made the decision.
Okay.
It wasn't. But look at every single newspaper has covered it. Every single newspaper.
Yeah, now,
so you say
now,
oh, something
wait, now,
bad
after the election.
Something
now.
Bad. Something bad didn't get reported the way I like it. Therefore, the election shouldn't be trusted. Cut it out.
All these newspapers covered it after the election.
They covered it when they had access to the laptop.
It was a decision.
And by the way, do you remember in 2016 when the Russians tried to hack our election? How did they do it with disinformation in October?
So now forever, because the Russians did something 7 years ago,
you should be suspicious.
Any piece of information that will not help the Democrats turns right back into Russian disinformation.
No, I want to tell you something.
How about peeing on a bunch of hookers in a Moscow hotel?
If this fell out of the sky and the only New York Post would cover it and they wouldn't share it with anyone else, I'd be suspicious too. So would you.
Well, no, I would not be. But of course you'd be suspicious.
You should be.
Because you're on the crazy team.
By the way, but it was on every...
You're on the crazy
team. Every newspaper covered it before November.
No, they did not.
Listen,
every newspaper covered it after, and they apologized.
Only
New York Times, Washington Post.
Access. Why? Can I ask you something? Why did Rudy Giuliani not let anyone but the New York Post have access to
it?
When NBC asked for it, they said they wouldn't.
Call Rudy.
When the New York Times asked for it, they said we won't give it to you because it was sus. It was suspect.
There was nothing suspect.
And by the way, to say, I don't trust the election where he lost by 9 million votes.
Oh, stop! All of a sudden, there was 80 million votes for Joe Biden.
Some story. Yeah.
I mean, Anthony, he got 71 million votes and lost. I mean, how ridiculous is that?
And in 1992, they got 30 million and won. Of course.
30 million.
It goes up every...
80 million votes and he won by 9 million. You can't be that silly.
You're one of these wackadoos who think the election's not on the level. This is why I don't support
Zeldin. But here's the problem. It's not a wackadoo. The more we speak to people like you that are so in the bag with Democrats...
65 lawsuits contesting the elections. Million. They all lost in front of Republicans.
65 lawsuits.
You see, doing a disservice to democracy. You're doing a disservice. If you're not going to trust the results unless you win, you're in the wrong business.
Stacey Abrams, is she a good candidate right now? You like Stacey Abrams?
I do like Stacey Abrams. She's going
to
lose.
She swears to death that she lost a rigged election.
That's not true. 100%
true.
That's not true. She doesn't say a rigged election.
She said the election was rigged in Georgia.
You remove polling places from districts where she was strong to make it harder.
Oh, my. You remove polling places. You find 19,000 votes on the board.
You stop a count in 2000 against Gore. Here's the difference. No one says the election is rigged. You can say, I don't like the way it turned out. I don't like the Electoral College.
Semantics.
It's not the same.
Oh, well, those semantics.
It's not semantics.
Right. It is semantics.
You're not semantics, because here's the difference. Yeah. Lee Zeldin voted to throw out your vote.
Okay.
Okay? That's crooked. That's corrupt. That's undermining democracy. I can never vote for a man like
that. That's what Biden did, and the country did with Donald Trump.
Well, how?
I just explained it to you. I'm not going to do it again. I only have like 4 more minutes on this.
What, that some story about Hunter Biden's laptop didn't get reported in the New York Times?
Or the fact that all of a sudden they started finding votes days, weeks,
not
months
true.
Later
happen.
And every
you see,
single Pennsylvania,
kinda,
Wisconsin,
that's not true.
And Georgia, and Arizona.
Every
course,
single one of
true.
What about the audit you did in Arizona looking for those things by Republicans? Found absolutely nothing. In fact, found more votes for Biden. By the Republicans. Yeah. It was done by the Republicans.
No, but they found more votes for Biden. I wonder how they found
them. Because they did an audit.
I wonder how
what about
votes
the audit in Michigan
there?
By Republicans that showed that Biden won? Yeah. Every single, what about all of the court cases?
All these states, amazingly Democrat votes.
These are
ended
Republicans.
Up there. We found them.
Republicans.
We found
these are Republicans.
We found them.
Republicans in Arizona, they control the legislatures. Catch up. Republicans in Michigan control the legislature. Catch up.
Right.
These are Republicans. Republican judges that were appointed by Trump throughout these cases.
Yeah.
This does it. We're going to talk about this on The Middle tomorrow. This does a disservice to democracy, because if you say you're only going to trust the results that you win, how can we trust anything? I'm not saying don't contest it in the courts, but when you contest in the courts and you lose, right now, Donald Trump still says this was stolen. And so do you.
Listen,
so does Lee Zeldin.
The courts aren't always perfect, my friend.
This is what...
Let me remind
How many,
you.
63 cases.
Let me remind you.
63
OJ
cases.
OJ Simpson continues to play golf and bang white kids.
63 cases. All right. How about this?
Let me explain that to you.
Point to a single case that Trump won. I'm waiting.
I don't care.
You don't care because you don't care. Because the truth
doesn't mean it's not true.
The truth doesn't matter.
Of course it matters.
Listen, in that case,
the criminal justice system must get everything right. They don't get everything right. They make plenty of mistakes.
That woman who's running for governor in Arizona says she'll only accept the results if she wins. Is that democracy?
I think so. Is that the end of this conversation?
It apparently is, because I believe in a different democracy.
That's fine. I like that democracy. All right, let me get to, on a serious note now, let's get to one of the other stories you wanted to talk about. Oh, you mentioned Hochul and Zeldin. What was Zeldin? Oh, we wanted to talk about...
Well, let's do Hochul and Zeldin for a minute. Look, I think that, by the way, and this is, you're going to... I think it's outrageous that Hochul won't debate. I think she should do 5-6 debates. She is not well known. She got elected as lieutenant governor. I could, you know, you a hand told me my Bible, I wouldn't know she was lieutenant governor.
How many times when you ran did you debate him?
Oh, my God. All the time. Even when I was running against a guy named Bob Turner, I think you may know.
I like Bob.
I love Bob.
He's a friend of mine.
And it was 2010. This was Obamacare was out. I was getting my butt kicked in my fairly conservative district. Everywhere. I'm like, I want to go talk about this stuff. I want to go talk, because I believed in it. Hochul to be hiding under her desk doing millions of dollars in ads, because if I can stand and debate you about this stuff, she, as the governor, this is what her job is.
Correct.
This is what her job is. And hopefully the one benefit of the polls closing is hopefully Hochul says, all right, let me do 5 or 6 debates with this guy because I can take him. I mean,
but you can't take him.
Well, she can. By the way, Zeldin was not very good in those debates, the Republican debates. Andrew Giuliani got under his skin. That other rich guy got under his skin.
No, it's Rob Astrino is his name. He's not some other rich guy.
The guy who he really hated that guy.
I want to talk to you about this 10-city deal in Randall's Island. I think you're a fan of Mayor Eric Adams, right?
I support my mayor.
I mean, you're such a team. You're like, it's come on, man.
What am I caught on?
Step out of your comfort zone. You want common sense Democrat?
That's what I am.
Okay, so are you allowed to be critical of another Democrat? You're not allowed to do that.
I just did it with Hochul just now.
because she won't debate. That's where you ended the criticism. How about the fact that she's corrupt?
Listen, you even take my criticisms and you say they're not critical enough. I do a different type of thing than you do. I do common sense facts. I don't do just this right or left.
Mayor Eric Adams, is he doing a good job or not?
I think he's doing a good job, but I would like him to be doing
some
things better.
Even that was like, good.
I think he's doing a good job. Look, this is a tough time. Crime is up. Yeah, crime is up all over the country. It's up more in Republican areas than it is in Democratic areas.
You're going to do that again? Are you really going to do that again?
It's the facts.
No, it's not a fact.
Crime per capita. Per capita is up more in Trump carry districts than in Democrat carry districts.
Right. So you feel safe taking the subways here in New York City?
I do.
You do?
I don't get scared.
You don't get scared.
No.
Well, you've been to prison. It doesn't matter.
I mean, what am I? Like, just crime. By the way, you and I are the same age. We lived through the 90s. This is nothing. This is nothing.
Well, I wouldn't say it's nothing. Was the 90s worse than the 70s?
Oh, my.
No.
Well, the 90s were worse than the 70s. Okay. Yeah, because the 70s, the city emptied out. We had an empty city. It was on fire.
But then we had our colleague and friend who you've said horrible things about so far today, Rudy Giuliani, come and save this city.
That's true. But when was crime lowest? When was crime lowest in the city?
What do you mean? What year?
No, under what mayor?
Though if you go David Dinkins, I'm going to punch you out across
the face.
It's
De Blasio.
Oh, he's the worst
mayor. But we hired a bunch of cops. By the way, this is what we should do today. Serious point now before we break. We should hire a bunch more cops. A bunch more mental health officers. We should lean into this problem. That's the problem I have with, you know, it's not really a problem I have with Adams because I think he wants to, but I think this legislature is so wackadoo, the city council.
True.
But I think we should hire a bunch more cops, a bunch more mental health experts.
I agree.
You know, and we should really, and a bunch more jail guys for the prisons, and that's how we lean into this problem.
I agree. So what do you think about this whole tent city thing? What's your opinion on that?
It's a bad situation, but what are we going to do?
What are we going to do? You got to put him in, it's got to be a happy medium, Anthony. You mean, what are we going to do?
No, you got to put him
somewhere.
You got
to give him Xbox?
Oh, an Xbox. You're focusing on the Xbox. Look, they're trying to...
I'm focusing on all the luxuries
you
they're giving
children,
these people.
You have children in these places. These are families.
No, you have 50 male adults. No. 50... Don't tell me no. 50 male adults on Randall's Island. Why do they even have Xboxes? No kids.
I heard the same thing. Why do they have cable TV in prison? I don't think it's a big deal.
Did you have cable TV in prison?
I think I stayed out of the TV rooms in prison. That's where you get into fights. That's where you get into fights. So I stayed away from that. If there was a knitting club and a synagogue for me and a chapel for me to go to, that's why I went.
No, but you have to agree. This is a bit much. I understand that you want to treat them humanely, but...
Wait a minute. No, but they're getting criticized on the other side because it's not humane enough because you're putting them in this big tent, and technically speaking, it's probably in violation of the rules we have here. I think we have a very bad court decision in this city. It's going to sound mean for me to say this. Requiring housing to be given to someone. Requiring it. It's the only city in the whole country that has that. That court decision...
LA doesn't have that.
No. We are required to do it by a court decree that was entered into the Dinkins years. It was a bad idea. We agreed to it, so we can't really get out of it now. So we have to provide housing for everyone that comes here.
Gotcha.
But it leaves very little flexibility. He's doing the best again. We're getting thousands of these. And by the way, where are they coming from? They're coming from Venezuela, a far left collapsed state that we put all these sanctions on. They can't sell oil. So all the 10% of the population is left. 2 million people have left Venezuela. They're going to find their way here. They crossed six countries to get here.
Right.
Okay.
Right.
So these people, I mean, to some degree, and I heard Bill O'Reilly allude to this, we have to have some, as we say in our faith, rachmunis for these people.
Oh, I do.
But you got to put them somewhere. I give credit to the administration for at least trying. We have to, the border is out of control. We have to get this thing fixed, but we need lawmakers to get
Kamala
it fixed.
Harris said, and Joe Biden said the border is secure.
Well, saying that, I mean, look, we're arresting a bunch of people, but people are showing up.
Even there. I gave you a softball to say, well, they're liars. You go, well, we've arrested a bunch of people.
We've arrested 2 million people more than Donald Trump ever did.
Oh, because he didn't have to. He built walls that didn't come.
That's baloney. We had some caravans, but this is the worst. Remember, he complained about the caravan in 2019. This is worse than the caravan.
Much worse.
But listen, part of the problem is if we're going to try to collapse countries overseas like we did with Venezuela, we got to be prepared for this because they're going to want to come to our country.
All right, fair enough. That's Anthony Weiner, who's a very, very smart guy. All kidding aside, he's well thought out. He knows what he's talking about. His show is terrific, 2 to 3 on Saturday afternoons, and then 3 to 4 with Curtis Lee. That was a very spirited conversation.
And I'll see you on Tuesday at the service for Bernie. It's so great that's being done.
I'm glad you'll be there on Tuesday. I'll be there on Wednesday for everybody else.
Is it Wednesday? I apologize. All right. You know, you can't win for losing in this show. You cannot win.
You were great. Thank you very much.
Thanks for having me, pal.
Anthony Weiner, 2 to 4 on Saturdays. I'll be back right after this. Everybody's going off the deep end.